FSC Biology Revision and Preparation Chapter 4 Second Half and is most important due to high weightage in the PPSC test for lecturer biology and zoology as well as subject specialist. In previous part, we discussed first 10 topics and in this part, we shall discuss remaining 10 topics from glyoxysome to difference of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Stay tuned and please watch it here online. Let's dive together. Glyoxysome. Glyoxysome are found only in plants like plastids, and please remember that glyoxysome are among those organelles which are only present in plants. They are abundant in plants seedlings, mean those plants which have just started their growth from the seeds and are very young. They convert stored fatty acids in seeds into energy to begin new plant, because new plants obtain energy from the seeds and those energy is prepared by glyoxysomes. So glyoxylate cycle, that's very important to note here. Glyoxylate cycle convert fatty acids into carbohydrates in glyoxysome, and that cycle is a cascade of reactions or pathway of many reactions. Peroxisomes play catabolic and anabolic roles in plants both. Castor bean and soybean seeds are rich in lipids. That's important thing to remember. Castor bean and soybean seeds are rich in lipids. Glyoxysomes convert fatty acids into succinate in such seeds, mean those seeds which are rich in lipids. Glyoxylates convert fatty acids into succinate. Glyoxysomes are present for short period in lipid-rich seeds, and they are not present throughout life. They are absent in lipid poor seeds like pea. So MCQs can be asked that which plant seeds are rich in lipids and which are poor in lipids. Vacuoles. Vacuoles are large and abundant in plant cells and push organelles aside. Large vacuoles are formed by coalescence of smaller ones during growth or fusion of smaller molecules during development or growth. Vacuoles serve as storage of water, and metabolic intermediates are also stored in the vacuoles. Vacuoles prevent dilution of cytosol or cytoplasm. They are major contributor to turgor, which provide rigidity to leaves and younger parts of the plants in the form of support. They are single membrane bound, which is called tonoplast. The membrane which surround vacuoles in plants is called as tonoplast, and that's important term to remember. Cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton proteins are tubulin, actin, myosin and tropomyosin. These four proteins are important to remember. Tubulin, actin, myosin and tropomyosin are the proteins which constitute or make cytoskeleton. Microtubules are part of cytoskeleton and are made up of tubulin proteins. That MCQ has already been asked in the past papers. Cilia, flagella, basal bodies and centrioles are assemblies of microtubules. When microtubules assemble together, then these structures are formed. Amoeboid and cyclosis movements are due to microfilaments. So microfilaments are responsible for the movements of amoeba and cyclia. Intermediate filaments determine cell shape and integrate compartments. So intermediate filaments have their function in the cell shape determination and compartment integration or compartment keeping them together. Microtubules are long, slender, unbranched tubulin protein structures. They assemble and disassemble spindles in mitosis. That's important thing to remember, and that also has been asked in the past papers. Which part of cytoskeleton or which tubulin assemble and disassemble spindles? Microfilaments, on the other hand, are made from actin protein and are more slender. They help internal cell motion. So what is internal cell motion? The motion of organelles and fluids in the cell. Intermediate filaments are in between ट्यूब्यूल्स एंड फिलामेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू साइज, दैट्स वाई दे आर नेम्ड एज इंटरमीडिएट फिलामेंट्स ड्यू टू द साइज इन बिटवीन ट्यूब्यूल्स एंड फिलामेंट्स एंड द फंक्शन ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट फिलामेंट इज टू मेंटेन शेप ऑफ द सेल. सेंट्रियोल्स, सेंट्रियोल्स आर एबसेंट इन हायर प्लांट्स, दैट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म टू रिमेंबर और फैक्ट. Each centriole is consisted of 9 microtubule triplets. So triplets mean each microtubule among the 9 is further made up of 3 tubules. 2 centrioles are placed at right angle to each other, external to nucleus. Centrioles play role in location of furrowing in cytokinesis. During cytokinesis, when cytoplasm is divided, then where the cell membrane or plasma membrane will furrow or invaginate is decided by centrioles and form cilia. Centrioles also form cilia. Spindle fibers are formed when they move opposite poles during cell division. Mitochondria. Mitochondria are powerhouse of eukaryotic cells because they are absent in prokaryotic cells and they form ATP, which is energy currency. They appear like rods of filaments or vesicles under microscope. So that question has also been asked. That's why I have included here that in under microscope, how mitochondria looks. So they look like rods of filaments or vesicles. They are double membrane bound. Outer membrane is smooth and inner has infoldings. Folds in inner membrane which extend in matrix are called cristae, and that important definition to remember, cristae. Mitochondria has their own DNA and ribosomes. They are self-replicating organelles that they can replicate in the cell even when the cell is not dividing. Inner layer has small knob-like structures, the F1 particles. F1 particles also have been asked in the past papers. Matrix consists of enzymes, coenzymes, salts for Krebs cycle, respiration and metabolism. So the matrix of the mitochondria, the fluid of the mitochondria has these kind of chemicals. Cristae is made up of lipoproteins having different enzymes in it. So another important MCQ to remember that cristae chemically is a lipoprotein. F1 particles are embedded in cristae or on cristae, you can say. When cristae ruptures or broken, F1 particles comes on the surface. That's another important thing to remember. Now F1 particles actually convert ADP into ATP by combining a phosphate group into ADP. Mitochondria convert food into ATP. The cells which have high metabolic activities have more number of mitochondria because they need more energy. For example, muscle cells, and those cells which are lower in metabolism have less number of mitochondria. Chloroplast. Pigment containing. Pigments are those chemicals which show or impart some kind of color. So due to color, the name pigment. Pigment containing organelles are plastids and present only in plants like glyoxysomes. Green pigment containing membrane bound plastids are chloroplast. There are three types of plastids and we shall discuss it later. The green pigment is chlorophyll, which is an organic compound. Chlorophyll molecules resemble heme molecule of hemoglobin. How? Chlorophyll has magnesium ion in the center, while heme molecule has iron ion in the center, and that is the major difference between heme and chlorophyll chemistry. Diameter of chloroplast range about 4 to 6 micrometer. There are three structures in chloroplast: envelope, outer membrane, stroma, inner matrix, and thylakoid sacs. Most of the volume is covered by stroma, which has circular DNA. That means chloroplast also have their own DNA, and that DNA is circular, and ribosomes also. Carbon dioxide is fixed in stroma. to manufacture sugars, and also protein are synthesized in the stroma. So please remember this fact, that in stroma CO2 is fixed. Thylakoid are flattened sacs or vesicles which arrange to form grana. There are 50 or more thylakoids stocked in a single granum. Chlorophyll molecules are arranged on the thylakoid, that's why it is green. So which part of chloroplast is mostly green? That is granum or thylakoids. Each granum is interconnected. One sac of thylakoid is connected with other sac of thylakoids through non-green intergranum. Please remember that in the chloroplast, intergranum are those linking structures which are not green. Sunlight is trapped on membranes of grana or thylakoid, because grana is constituted of thylakoid, and ATP is formed there. Chloroplasts are self-replicating bodies like mitochondria, because they have their own circular DNA. All colors except green are due to chromoplast in petals and flowers and in ripened fruits, etc. So that is the second type of plastids, chromoplast. Chrome mean color. Chromoplast help in pollination and seed dispersal, because they attract birds and insects for the seeds as well as for the nectar, and those insects are responsible for pollination, and then birds which eat the fruits are responsible for seed dispersal. Leucoplasts are colorless. That is the third type of plastid. They are colorless, they are triangular in shape, and that triangular shape is important to remember, because I have seen this MCQ in the past papers. Triangular shaped plastids are, so they are leucoplasts. And they are found in underground parts like roots, and they mainly store food. Nucleus. Robert Brown reported nucleus in 1831 for the first time properly. It control life and activities of cell. Life and activities of cell. Usually cells are mononucleate, mean they have one nucleus, but they can be dinucleate or multinucleate and have two nuclei or many nuclei. Nucleus in animal cell is in center, while in plants it is pushed near periphery due to large vacuole. Nucleus can only be seen when a cell is not dividing, because during cell division the nuclear membrane ruptures or disappears and chromosomes are in the cytoplasm. Inside the nucleus, soluble sap, this term is important to remember, soluble sap is called nucleoplasm. So all the nucleoplasm is soluble, which contain chromatin. Chromatins are threads of genetic material. Heredity material is in the form of chromosome. So chromatin is not called as heredity, because chromatin is not inherited into the parents. While chromatin is condensed, then it converts into chromosomes, and actually chromosomes are transferred or shifted from parents to offspring. That's why chromosome is termed as hereditary material. Chemically, nucleus have DNA, RNA and proteins with some enzymes. Nuclear membrane has pores for exchange of materials between nucleoplasm and cytoplasm. There are almost 30,000 pores in egg cells, while only 3 to 4 pores in erythrocytes. Nucleolus, another important organelle in the nucleus. Organelle you may called a structure. Darkly stained body in the nucleus without membrane is nucleolus. Ribosomal RNA is synthesized and stored in the nucleolus. Nucleolus has two regions, peripheral or outer granular region, while the central fibril area or fibril region. Granular area has ribosomal subunits, precursors, mean the subunits of ribosomes, smaller and larger, are present in the granular area, and those are the precursors or base for the formation or synthesis of ribosomes. Fibril area has large molecular weight, RNAs and ribosomal DNA, important thing to remember. Ribosomes are also assembled in nucleolus, and then they are exported out. क्रोमोसोम्स, क्रोम इन कलर. न्यूक्लियस इज डीपली स्टेन्ड विद बेसिक डाइज ड्यू टू क्रोमेटिन. डार्कली स्टेन्ड थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स इन न्यूक्लियस आर क्रोमोसोम्स एंड डार्कली स्टेन्ड स्पॉट इज न्यूक्लियोलस. क्रोमोसोम्स हैव आर्म्स एंड सेंट्रोमेयर. सेंट्रोमेयर काइनेटोकोर, एक्चुअली काइनेटोकोर इज अ प्रोटीन. सो इन द सेंट्रोमेयर काइनेटोकोर प्रोटीन इज द प्लेस वेयर स्पिंडल फाइबर्स अटैच. क्रोमेटिड इज एग्जैक्ट रेप्लिका ऑफ क्रोमोसोम और एग्जैक्ट कॉपी ऑफ क्रोमोसोम विच इज अ डुप्लीकेटेड फॉर्म एंड दैट इज नीडेड बिफोर सेल डिवीजन. केमिकली क्रोमोसोम्स आर मेड अप ऑफ डीएनए एंड प्रोटीन्स. जीन्स आर प्रेजेंट ऑन क्रोमोसोम्स विच आर यूनिट्स ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. ह्यूमन हैज 46 क्रोमोसोम, फ्रॉग हैज 26, चिंपेंजी हैज 48, फ्रूट फ्लाई और ड्रोसोफिला मेलानोगेस्टर हैज 8, ऑनियन हैज 16, पोटैटो हैज 48 एंड पी हैज और गार्डन पी हैज 14 क्रोमोसोम्स. इंपॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज टू रिमेंबर. नाउ जर्म सेल्स हैव हैप्लॉइड और हाफ क्रोमोसोम्स बिकॉज दे आर फॉर्म्ड आफ्टर मियोसिस एंड मियोसिस इज अ रिडक्शन डिवीजन. प्रोकैरियोटिक वर्सेस यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स. यूकैरियोट्स हैव प्रोमिनेंट न्यूक्लियस विद न्यूक्लियर एनवेलप व्हाइल प्रोकैरियोट्स डू नॉट हैव एनी न्यूक्लियस और न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन. बैक्टीरिया एंड ब्लू ग्रीन एल्जी आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड फेमस एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ प्रोकैरियोट्स. प्रोकैरियोट्स लैक मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड स्ट्रक्चर्स लाइक माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया, एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम, क्लोरोप्लास्ट एंड गॉल्जी अपरेटस. राइबोसोम्स ऑफ प्रोकैरियोट्स आर स्मॉल विच आर 70 स्वेडबर्ग यूनिट्स व्हाइल यूकैरियोट्स आर 80 स्वेडबर्ग यूनिट्स एंड दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट टू रिमेंबर. माइटोसिस इज मिसिंग इन प्रोकैरियोट्स एंड दे यूज बाइनरी फिशन इंस्टेड टू डिवाइड एंड रिप्रोड्यूस. मोस्ट डिस्टिंक्ट फीचर ऑफ प्रोकैरियोट इज सेल वॉल मेड फ्रॉम पॉलीसेकेराइड्स एंड अमाइनो एसिड. सो पॉलीसेकेराइड एंड अमाइनो एसिड कलेक्टिवली फॉर्म म्यूरिन और पेप्टाइडोग्लाइकेन. देयर सेल वॉल इज कंसिडर्ड एज सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल. सेल वॉल ऑफ प्रोकैरियोट्स इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल एंड इज कॉल्ड एज सकुलस. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर द टर्म सकुलस इज अ मॉलिक्यूल विच इज एक्चुअली द सेल वॉल ऑफ प्रोकैरियोट्स. दैट्स फॉर चैप्टर 4. इंशाल्लाह अपकमिंग वीडियो इज ऑफ चैप्टर 5 कंप्लीट कंसेप्ट एंड सम कनेक्टेड. एंड प्लीज लाइक एंड शेयर द वीडियोज एज वेल. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग.